This is Business Analytics Using Forecasting. I'm Galit Shmueli. In this video, we're going to expand the discussion from autoregressive models, AR models, to a larger family called ARIMA models. The idea in ARIMA models is to also capture autocorrelation, but in a more elaborate way, and we're going to capture it directly. ARIMA models are used only for forecasting. They're less interpretable than linear regression models that we saw earlier on, but they're very, very useful for forecasting. They have a strong underlying mathematical and statistical theory, which means that it will be easier to generate predictive intervals. They're also very flexible and can capture lots of different types of patterns. The key concepts in ARIMA models are the order, like what we discussed in the AR model, and we're also going to revisit a concept that we talked about earlier, which is differencing. Recall the AR model that was introduced in the previous video. This is just one member of the ARIMA family. It includes predictors that are lagged versions of the series. A more complex model is the ARMA PQ model, which includes as predictors, in addition to the P lagged series, also Q lagged versions of the forecast errors. These forecast errors are called the moving average component of this model, and hence the name autoregressive moving average, or simply an ARMA model. The idea of the ARMA model is to capture all forms of autocorrelation by including lags of the series and of the forecast errors. The ARMA model, which includes the AR model as a special case, also assumes that the series is stationary. Remember that this means no trend, no seasonality, a constant level, constant variance, and autocorrelations that remain steady throughout the entire series. Like all the models we discussed in this course, the ARMA models also extrapolate patterns from the past into the future. So we therefore assume that the future will remain similar to what we've seen in the past. The last step, which moves us from ARMA to ARIMA models, is adding a differencing step called integrate. Hence, the ARIMA model stands for autoregressive integrated moving average model, or simply ARIMA. This differencing operator is exactly the one that we saw earlier, which we use to remove trend and or seasonality. In ARIMA modeling, we first apply differencing, typically lag 1 for removing trend, or seasonal differencing, and then we fit an ARMA model to the differenced series. Let's look more closely at the differencing procedure in ARIMA. We use a lag 1 differencing to remove trend. The parameter D in ARIMA PDQ tells us how many times to apply the lag 1 differencing. D equals 0 means no differencing. D equals 1 means that we difference once at lag 1. And D equals 2 means double differencing. After differencing the original series at lag 1, we again difference the difference series, again at lag 1. The same logic applies to what's called seasonal differencing. You'll see that we can also fit seasonal ARIMA models, which have two sets of parameters, small PDQ and capital PDQ. As we just saw, the small d refers to the lag 1 differencing, and the capital D will refer to the seasonal differencing. For a cycle with m seasons, we use lag m differencing to remove seasonality. The parameter capital D denotes whether or not to perform seasonal differencing, where 0 indicates no seasonal differencing, and 1 indicates applying seasonal differencing once. ARIMA models require the user to specify the parameters P, D, Q, and capital P, D, and Q. This is not a simple choice and requires some experience and expertise. The typical method for determining these parameters is using visual inspections of the series to detect seasonality and trend, as well as looking at the autocorrelation chart and another chart called partial autocorrelations. A lag K partial autocorrelation is the lag K autocorrelation after accounting for all the autocorrelations at lower lags, k-1, k-2, and so forth. Choosing the parameters based on visual inspection is based on different rules of thumb, such as a slowly decreasing autocorrelation chart combined with a sharp decline in the partial autocorrelation chart calls for q equals 0 and P equal to the largest partial autocorrelation. A few general tips are to use differencing to remove trend and seasonality, to keep the model as simple as possible by differencing at most one time, choosing low values of small p and q, and setting capital P and q to 0 or 1. Lastly, over-differencing can cause quite a bit of trouble, so beware of performing more than the necessary differencing operations. Professor Robert Now gives the following rule of thumb. In most cases, either p is 0 and q is 0, and p plus q is less than or equal to 3. Choosing the ARIMA parameters is beyond the scope of this course. You can find more details in the article by Professor Robert Now. And we'll briefly look at an example soon. Instead of doing this manually, let's look at choosing ARIMA parameters using automated selection. Luckily, some software do allow automated selection of these parameters. What they do is they try a whole range of values and they choose the best model according to some metric. This is very useful, especially if we have to forecast many series. That's the case in big data. The issues are that different software will give you slightly different results because the performance is very sensitive to how you implement the algorithm. So it's always useful to inspect which model was automatically selected by the software and then check what exactly it chose and why. Let's return to our monthly ridership on Amtrak example so that we can illustrate how to use these models. Recall that this series has trend, it has seasonality, and therefore we cannot apply AR or ARMA or ARIMA models directly because we first have to address the seasonality and the trend. Recall that a while back we talked about using differencing to remove the seasonality and the trend. We use the lag 1 to remove the trend. We use the lag 12 to remove seasonality, and when we double differenced with both of them, we got a series that has no trend and no seasonality. This is similar to what we would do when we ran an ARIMA model with D equals 1 and capital D equals 1. Here we plotted the autocorrelation chart of the difference series, and we see negative autocorrelations at lags 1 and 12. Next, we look at the partial autocorrelations chart. These partial autocorrelations will be the betas in the ARP model. In this chart, we see the most pronounced partial autocorrelations at lags 1 and 12. Based on these, we would choose PQ, capital P and Q, that would capture a lag 1 and a seasonal pattern. Let's use automated software selection next. R's forecast package has a function called auto.arima that performs automated model selection. The user must specify a time series object. If the time series is monthly, auto.arima will also try 12-month seasonal ARIMA models. If the series is quarterly, it will try quarterly seasonal ARIMA models. In our case, the result of the automated model selection is an ARIMA 111011 model. This means that the series was differenced once at lag 1 and once at lag 12. After the differencing, the model includes y sub t minus 1 and e sub t minus 1 and a seasonal lag 12 error term. The time plot shows the forecast as well as the prediction intervals for this selected model. We can also try to manually fit a simpler model, such as by dropping the seasonal term. This can be done with the ARIMA function. Let's compare the two models. The top chart is the actual and forecasts, and the bottom is the forecast errors. Orange is the automatically selected model, and blue is the manually simpler model. We can see that the models are very similar, but that the manual model has larger peaks and dips in the error series. We also see that in the validation period, the automated model performs better. But the magnitude of the differences between the models is around 100 units. Whether this is substantial or not depends on how our forecasts will be used. In Excel Miner, there is no automated ARIMA model selection procedure. But let's manually choose the best model that R gave us. We do this by setting the ARIMA parameters in the dialog box. We must also specify the seasonality type. The result looks similar, but not identical to R's coefficients. Let's see what happens if we now try the simpler model in XL minor. How will it compare with this model? Here we see the same charts as before, only that this time we used XL minor for estimating the ARIMA models. Surprisingly, we see here that the simpler model, which we chose manually, performs better in the validation period. What does this mean? It means that software implementation of ARIMA differs across different software. The best model in one software is not necessarily the best in another. So to summarize ARIMA models, this is a flexible family of models that capture autocorrelation in all kinds of forms. It has a strong statistical foundation, and therefore it's easy to get automated prediction intervals, as we saw with the R-code. It does assume and require a stationary series, meaning no trend and no seasonality, and it assumes that this autocorrelation remains fixed throughout the period. Fitting manually an ARIMA model requires expertise and experience. You need to know how to choose these many parameters, PDQ and capital PD and Q. Luckily, we can also use automated selection. Beware of overfitting if you're trying lots of different ARIMA models. And remember that this model is excellent for forecasting, but quite difficult to explain or interpret. And therefore, if interpretability is very important, ARIMA models might not be your favorite choice. Automated model selection is very useful, especially when you have many series that you need to forecast. But remember that it's very sensitive to implementation, and therefore different software, even different versions of the same software, might give you different results.